Hi everyone, Cake the Knee Cake Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it is time for a review of the new Logic album, No Pressure. Maryland native rapper, singer, producer, songwriter, Logic. He is back with a new full-length LP, No Pressure, the spiritual successor to his commercial debut back in 2014, Under Pressure, and interestingly enough, said to be his final album ever, as he, with this album, announced his retirement from hip-hop while also mentioning a seven-figure streaming deal with Twitch, making him a rapper-gone streamer now. Plus, for this spiritual successor to Under Pressure, Logic has linked back up with legendary producer No ID, who is credited as an executive producer on this album, which was one of a few reasons I was excited to hear it. That and Under Pressure I see as Logic's best album to date, so something connected to that, something that is a sequel to that, could also be good. Part of me also has to consider Logic's last couple of records and how disappointing those were, so I feel almost like he can't really go anywhere but up from there. Look, honestly, after having listened to it, I am just happy to report to you that this record is pretty low BS. There's no annoying, fake deep narrative threading throughout the whole thing that ends with a very lackluster conclusion. The closest we get to this is at the end of the record, we get a really cool anti-racist tirade from Total Chad Orson Welles, and the all-too-familiar voice of the Thalia computer program between tracks, giving us useless factoids about what Logic and his crew were doing during the recording of the album.
While writing this review, Anthony ate some potato chips and drank water at 1 a.m.
Thank you?
Live, laugh, love.
Thankfully, a vast majority of No Pressure's focus is on quality beats and flows, and giving longtime fans perspective on where Logic is mentally at this moment. Now, the sound and style of this record for Logic I view as nothing revolutionary. Not to say it's bad or anything like that, but if you've been a devout Logic hater up until this point, most likely there is nothing on this LP that is going to convince you, blow you away. However, if you can appreciate Logic for who he is, what he is, a hardcore rap fan who wears his influences on his sleeve and drops a lot of sick punchlines and flows while occasionally getting introspective over some hopefully classy production. Yeah, that is basically him in a nutshell. If you are okay with that, if you can appreciate that, honestly, No Pressure is Logic doing Logic best. Once again, to my ears, he is operating from a place where he sounds hungry, unencumbered, straightforward. Take the No Pressure intro, which features a chill, jazzy loop, super crispy beat, unbroken confidence on Logic's delivery and flow. Gangsters put that heat to your head like a hairdresser, the Rosa Parks B Rabbit line, also producing tracks for the underground like Harriet. Tons of gems and flows on this track that make it sound like a 90s hardcore hip-hop throwback with a jazz rap flow. Flair, and a modern punch. It is a short, simple, but quality tone setter for the record. Now, immediately after this, I do think the album's quality does dip a little bit. The melodic choruses on Hit My Line aren't all that great, and I think the somewhat cluttered production with these roaring bass synth lines just leaves a lot to be desired. Lyrically, I do think Logic drops some compelling lines, and his delivery is pretty passionate, but overall the tone of the song is somewhat mild. Then the song GP4 gets to the heart of one of my biggest consistent issues with Logic's catalog. That is that he'll blatantly redo another artist's sound or idea or borrow from a particular song or record very blatantly, which, okay, in hip-hop, recontextualizing things, sampling things, borrowing things is nothing new. But then Logic's flip of whatever he's borrowing will be so basic and obvious and so free of artistic liberties that it sounds like just a lesser version of whatever has inspired him, which in this case is basically Logic trying to rebuild the chorus and the overall vibe of the Outkast song Elevators. You and me,
can live together in this perfect harmony.
The hook and the beat just feels like a very basic knockoff of the original. For sure, there is something to be said with the slightly psychedelic embellishments in the production and Logic's many funny and clever lines and animated personality. That notorious B.I.G. keep it G, look it up to find the key to that punchline, the key, the note, you need to look it up, but it is a genius level fucking line. Also, that flattering Badu impression was very funny. The admirable existentialism bars on the song too. The pen game Logic showcases on this record is definitely something that's been missing on previous projects. Now, again, to remind you, I'm not particularly crazy about these two tracks, but there are still admirable aspects to them, and the quality of the record picks up immediately after. The song Celebration features an epic thumping beat, grand chorus samples, and a grainy, glamorous piano. Sounds kinda like some classic Kanye production, honestly. Which Logic's energy and impassioned flows capitalize on big time? There are gems on this track, like the getting under people's skin like Stitches and then going on from there to say no strings attached, let it dissolve, as some newer types of Stitches literally do that, they dissolve. That's just the tip of the iceberg of the standout bars though. The Silas feature in the second half is a nice add too. And most importantly, the song actually does feel like a celebration, a last hurrah for Logic essentially achieving his dreams in music. You know, I remember very early on in Logic's discography, while not being the biggest fan of it, he came off to me like a persona that you could really root for, that you want to see succeed, and tracks like this put me back in that mindset. Following this, we have Open Mic / Aquarius 3. I love the vibe of this track, just relentless flows on what feels like a pretty casual freestyle. The sound of Logic's voice on the microphone, it's like it's so close, it's in his frickin' mouth. And damn if there aren't more standout bars on this track too. Some standout dad bars, as Logic says, can't wait till my sunshine and together we rain? Shit! Always wanted more, like Roots in 95. Okay, do you want more? Good debut, I like that record too. Then lyrically, Logic is filing through his past a bit, wrestling with growing up around addiction and also not wanting to be taken away by a social worker. The beat switch in the last leg for the Aquarius portion of the song is pretty dope too. Very sweet sound delivered here. A lot of the bars in this portion are oriented around how Logic's life has changed since becoming a dad. Then with Soul Food 2, we have more fantastic production. Dry, punchy drums, colored with all these dramatic vocal samples and grand swaths of orchestral instrumentation. Logic spits relentlessly on this track, following through with some facts of life or fame in the music industry. Your new shit ain't as good as your old shit until your new shit is your old shit. The living behind these bars with no like intention to pay bail line is like, oh my god, what? Where have you been? There's also a portion of the track where there's a beat switch and Logic changes the narrative of the song too, and he starts going into some of the backstory of Thalia and some of the space-oriented stuff that's been on his previous records. I mean, if you're a hardcore fan, I suppose it's pretty interesting to get more context for this stuff, but for me, best moment was when he rapped Raptured with Rap Shit. The song Perfect is a short but kooky banger that I wish was longer, honestly. But I guess I still appreciate it as a brief transition point in the middle of the record that Logic uses to essentially bring the listener to a more serious side of the album. Lyrically, on the song Man I Is, Logic is coming to terms with himself, his flaws, his upbringing, the obstacles he navigated over the course of his lifetime. Now, if you're a hip-hop head, you might notice the horn section on this track is a little familiar. It originally comes from Tariqa Blue's Dream Flower, which serves as the backbone to Outkast's Spodeyote Dopealicious. But I can appreciate that in this context, Logic and Six took this sample and played it off way smoother and more laid back and almost loungy in comparison to how it was on the original Outkast cut. So the vibe is different. My main issue with this track though is that there's not much bite, and topically, while Logic is getting a little introspective on this track, he doesn't really go any deeper personally in my view here than he does on any other moment on the record. If he's really trying to face down and come to terms with the man and who he is here, I just feel like he doesn't dig that much more significantly than he does anywhere else. I mean, he's kind of facing down the man who he is all over this record, in a way. That's actually what I like so much about the song Dad Bod, a song that annoyed me a little bit at first, considering how repetitive the chord progression is on the track and how indignant and annoyed Logic comes off in his bars. However, the more I listened to it, the more I admired how raw and unfiltered and funny Logic comes off in this song. Basically admitting just how boring and domesticated his life has become since being a dad. I love my wife like I am Chance, and Bobby, better eat your greens, don't give me no lip about it. Dealing with manic depression on stage, having to clean baby shit, also getting pissed at the shitty internet quality at hotels when touring. In a bit of an Eminem-type moment, he is taking pictures with fans and scratching his dick before he shakes their hands. So while yes, what Logic is saying on this track is not super flashy or epic or anything like that, it is mega respectable just how much he lets it go here in terms of being honest about what his life has become and being comfortable with that. The song Five Hooks to My Ears is another celebratory banger in the track list, picks the mood up a little bit in the second half here. Lots of sick flows and one-liners, not as purposeful in style and in concept as the moments before that sort of scratched this same itch, but still enjoyable, still killer production. Then with the song Dark Place, the more introspective tone returns with an incredibly moody and desolate beat. Right from the start, the vibe of this track feels like one of those more sad musical monologues that Drake would work into an album at some point. But then lyrically, Logic goes on to admit the type of stuff that if Drake ever felt it on a track, you know that he would never admit it. That his confidence is shattered, that he's hated on every corner of the internet, that he even doesn't really enjoy writing bars and verses anymore, or at least he has a hard time writing them and overthinks every line, whereas in the past it was just easy and fun and really gratifying. Enjoy Logic's music or not, it is genuinely saddening to hear him sound authentically heartbroken over losing joy in this thing that obviously brought him so much happiness, brought him so much success. My biggest issue with the track, though, is that it could have used another verse. I think the very long-winded Alan Watts outro is a bit of a cop-out, though I do agree with what he says on materialism and status. More words from Logic, I think, would have had a higher emotional impact. Following this, we have the song A to Z, which in concept is kind of cute despite its very annoying production. It's essentially an alphabet rap with Logic trying to cleverly work in all of these nods to every letter of the alphabet as he is rapping. I remember the New York rapper Papoose blowing up off of something similar back in the day, but he would kind of go off on one single letter and like give you a bunch of A words like all together, but still like lyrically making sense, and B words and C words, whereas Logic is like quickly trying to mention each letter in succession, which if this is your concept, it just seems like a very roundabout way of executing it. You know, you've taken some very obvious shortcuts. But then, in a very odd decision, Logic decides to end this song with some demo of him rapping from the 2000s, which is very unflattering and miraculously makes the A to Z track sound a lot better by comparison. It's almost like, wow, this is my least favorite song on the record. And then the demo comes in, it's like, I mean, you know what, maybe it wasn't too bad. But yeah, I'm surprised he put that in. I am blown away that he left that in. But I guess it's his last album, so Following this, though, the album does have a very strong ending. There's the stunning Heard Him Say, which might be in the running for my favorite track here. There's a really wonderful and generous flip of Manfred Mann's Earth Band. The way Logic chipmunks the vocals on the hook of Lie Through the 80s and grabs the synthesizers from that track too, which sound very regal and classically influenced, and then gives them a lot of space, makes them sound really pristine. It's beautiful, it's epic, it's wonderful. Production-wise, a huge Kanye influence is embodied here, better, but it's done pretty creatively, especially when Logic is putting a certain brand of swagger on specific bars. Somebody beefing with you, that shit ain't rare. Lyrically on this track, Logic is just reinforcing more themes of being on your own path, making your own decisions, standing out, being your true self. Then the song Amen, it is kind of short, yes, but it runs a little like the No Pressure intro, high energy, hits you with a lot of bars, and it's a relatively powerful bow out. That is before the Orson Welles track hits, which is pretty dramatic. But yes, I enjoyed this record. I enjoyed it quite a bit. Overall, are Logic's bars on self-love and respect and self-assessment the best I've ever heard? No, not necessarily. But that doesn't stop all of this from still sounding like a very watershed moment for him, which comes out in his performance, comes out in the music, and that feeling, that sensation is pretty infectious. Plus, there are tons of standout lines on this thing, and the best production to land on any Logic project. Yes, I was not crazy about A to Z, and there were some songs that I thought were a little underwhelming, but No Pressure is still packed with admirable songs, flows, performances, witty writing, quite a few personal revelations as well. I can't help but be kind of happy for the guy, you know? Feeling a decent too strong 7 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Logic, No Pressure, forever.